We'll have to meditate on that. How does that sound? Okay, so we all have the prostitute archetype. It's one of the four survival archetypes. They have good sides, right? The light side and the shadow side. And sometimes when we hear just the word prostitute in general, we automatically jump to a conclusion. But all of us have prostituted ourselves at some point for survival reasons. And it's a good archetype to understand because it's also an archetype about boundaries. Like, do you have healthy boundaries? So let's close our eyes and draw our attention inward. And that first thing you may want to do is just start to acknowledge, where are my boundaries energetically? Do your no's mean no and your yes's mean yes? And the more grounded we are in ourself, the easier it is to establish healthy boundaries. One of the best ways to do that is to create a grounding cord in present time. So we'll let go of any grounding cords. So it looks like some of you have a few. And let's just create one brand new grounding cord that goes from the base of the spine down to the center of the planet. And you can begin to, on a very subtle level, feel this rush of energy starting to move through you. It goes right down the grounding cord into the center of the planet. So we want to move out of this place of our intellect and into this place of feel. And as you begin to feel more connected to the earth, notice how that changes your subtle body. Tamas, earth energy, is very comforting and healing. It's also very much about being in stillness. Now the mind can be spinning in all of its different disturbances, but we remove our energy from that. And we put all of our attention on being with the earth. We invite that feminine energy to come in through the feet, the leg channels, into the first chakra. Just balancing out the Shiva and the Shakti. And at the same time, we open up Father Sky and we invite the masculine to come in through the top of the head. It'll go down either side of the spinal column. And we'll go into the first chakra. We want to run our masculine and feminine energy at 50-50, 50% of each. Detach from the human doing. Allow yourself to unwind, whether it's physically, mentally, emotionally, or spiritually. And continue to distance yourself from your mind. The Yoga Sutras are all about mastering the mind. In the beginning, it talks about how we're consumed by it. And what we want to do is we want to put our attention on our mind, not be in it. This is another intuitive skill. Can we sit comfortably in our third eye and look at our mind psychically? What color is the mind? Is there a texture to it? Is there a weight to it? Does it come with a temperature? How big is it? What feeds it? What does it mirror back to you? How does your body respond to you putting your one pointed focus on the mind? What sensations arise? If you find your mind, yourself slipping into your mind, just call your energy back. And practicing seeing things intuitively. Versus empathically. If you need help redirecting your attention, then you just bring your awareness back to your grounding cord. Check in on your tools. Are you running your earth and cosmic energy? Operating from the third eye. Practicing social distancing from our minds. Making some space for your higher self to come through. Not making it work so hard to connect with you. Here's Archangel Michael. He is great for helping us cut cords. So ask Archangel Michael to cut any cords that are associated to disempowering you. And we start to call our energy back. And we imagine that there's a big gold sun above our head. One of the things we talked about is creative projects, that we have to put our energy into something for it to be created. But then that creation takes on a power of its own. It builds its own momentum. So begin to call all your energy back from your creative projects. And all that energy comes back into the big gold sun. And we bring that right back into the top of the head, filling up every cell within the skeletal system. Tomorrow is the full moon, and there is a full moon meditation tomorrow at 7. It's in Pisces, which means that the sky will open up. We're all going to be more sensitive. And this is a great time to plug in and connect with your higher self. In this sensitivity, you will find empowerment. In our vulnerability, we will find strength. In our compassion, we will find courage. And we'll stretch up towards the sky, come out of trance. And there's an opportunity to share anything that may have come up.